Let me introduce the next speaker, our seminar, Emilia Anna Alfano. The title of the talk is Dirichlet Problem for Non-Coercive Non-Linear Elliptic Equation in Unbounded Domain. Okay, please.
Good morning. Thank you for to introduce me and thank you to the organizers for the possibility to take this talk at this conference. Today, I'll speak about the Dirichlet problem for non-coercive non-linear elliptic equations studied in unbounded domains. And in this occasion, I present my last work with Sarah Monsoreau. We start seeing what we know, that is the state of art. We have existence, uniqueness, and regularity results for coercive linear problem in bounded domains. For non-coercive linear and non-linear equations studied in bounded domains, and later on for non-coercive linear equations in unbounded domains. For sake of completeness, I reported here the definition of a coercive operator. So we are able to introduce our aim. In fact, our goal regards the existence of the solution of a class of elliptic equations. In particular, what we want are equations that are non-coercive, non-linear, and studied in unbounded domains. We see the classical problem where omega is a subset of Rn with n is greater than 2. In particular, we have hypothesis 2 on M that says that M is an elliptic and bounded matrix. We have mu that is a positive constant, E that is a vector field, and F that is a real function. The milestones results about the previous problem are given by Guido Stampacchia in the 60s. In particular, he studies the classical problem one seen before, assuming omega an open bounded subset over n with n is greater than 2, and assuming the problem coercive and linear. I report for sake of completeness the paper that contains this result. We want to give relevance to the coercivity that is supposed. In fact, in order to obtain the coercivity of his problem, he proves in his papers that the problem is coercive if mu is supposed to be greater than zero and it is also large enough, or the norm of E in ln of omega is small enough. That is the same to require that the measure of omega is small enough. Under this hypothesis of coercivity, obviously, it is possible to use classical theorems. So, under opportune assumptions, and thanks to Lax-Milgram theorem, Stampacchia obtains existence and uniqueness result of the solution for his problem. I want also to recall Lucio Boccardo, because also Lucio Boccardo studied the previous problem in 2009 and in 2012. And in particular, we observe that he studied the problem in bounded domains, but in the non-coercive case, both in linear and in non-linear case, obtaining the same result of Stampacchia. So, all of these results have been obtained supposing the domain bounded. And now we are going to analyze some results, but in unbounded domains. In particular, our problem is also non-coercive and non-linear. First of all, we report the main difficulties that one meets when working on unbounded domains. In fact, there are no natural decreasing inclusions among the LP spaces. The classical compactness results are not valid. And moreover, the norm in W01P is not equivalent to the norm of gradient because Poincaré inequality does not hold. So, in view of these problems, the questions are two. Can we solve these problems? And in particular, how can we solve these problems? In order to answer to these two questions, we introduce, first of all, some notations. In particular, given omega, a subset over n with n is greater than 2, x in omega and r greater than 0, omega xr is the intersection between omega and the ball set in x and with radius r. Instead, by omega x, we denote the intersection between omega and the ball set in x and with radius 1. That is the picture that we see in the slide. So, given this notation, we are able to answer to the previous questions. In particular, first of all, we have to consider the following definitions. From now on, we assume omega an unbounded subset over n, and that P, where n is greater than 2, p is between 1 and plus infinity, and r is greater than 0. Mp denotes the space of all function f in Lp log of omega bar, such that 6 is verified and OID with the norm defined in 6. Instead, M0p is the subspace of Mp made up of all function f in Mp, such that the norm of f in Lp of omega x goes to 0 when modulus of x goes to plus infinity. We observe that the definition of these two spaces that is useful to overcome some difficulties that one meets when working on unbounded sets is introduced for the first time in the paper below by Maria Transirico and Mauro Troisi, but they proved also that for different r, the spaces are equivalent. So it is possible to choose r equal to 1, and so here, we have omega x that is taken with radius equal to 1. What is the importance to introduce this new class of spaces? Because these new spaces contains the classical Lebesgue ones, firstly, and moreover, given p and q in 1 plus infinity with p less than q, for these new spaces, the natural decreasing inclusions hold also in unbounded case. And the most important property on these spaces is the following theorem concerning the multiplication operator 8, where the function g belongs to Mn. In fact, these compactness results have been proved by Maria Transirico and Mario Troisi in a more general case, but here we report only a specific one that is useful for our aim. The theorem says that if G belongs to M0n, then the operator 8 is compact. And the importance of this result is due to the fact that, thanks to a compactness result, we can pass to the limit also in the non-coercive term, as we can see in a few minutes. Now we are able to answer to the previous questions. In particular, for the first problem, we have seen that for empty spaces, the natural decreasing inclusions hold. So in particular, we suppose that the coefficients of our problem belong to the intersections between these spaces with the LP ones for a suitable P. In order to solve instead the second problem, we exploit a compactness result on M0p spaces. And since the norm in W01p is not equivalent to the norm of gradient when omega is unbounded, it is necessary to take mu greater than 0 in the equation of our problem. Now, we are able to introduce our results contained in a paper joint with Professor Monsurrot. In particular, in the paper that I reported below, we studied the existence of problems that are non-coercive, non-linear, and studied in unbounded domains. We consider the following problem where the domain is unbounded and under the following assumptions. In particular, we focus on the assumptions on the coefficients E and F. Obviously, we have that P first and P star are beholder and Sobolev conjugate respectively. So the unboundedness of the domain omega lead us to take the following assumptions on the coefficients. In fact, we notice that for E and F, the intersection between some spaces, because when there isn't the boundedness of the set, there is a known result that says that if a function belongs to the intersection between some spaces, it belongs to every intermediate space. Moreover, we notice that one of these spaces is a non-zero p-space for a suitable p in order to overcome the difficulties on unbounded sets. Mu that is greater than zero is due to avoid the lack of the equivalence between norms in W01p, because we know that Poincaré inequality does not hold. The non-coercive operator of our problem is this one. In fact, it is possible to prove that this operator does not satisfy the following definition of coercivity. And we notice that we take mu greater than zero since omega is unbounded, but not large enough, and we have no smallness assumptions on the norm of E. This guarantees that our problem still remains non-coercive in order to the previous result obtained by Stampacchia. Moreover, we notice also that the coefficients that is in the non-coercive term as supposed to belong to the intersection between an LP space and an MP space for suitable P. And this is done in order to overcome the lack of compactness result on the non-coercive term. We give just a few preliminary informations as the Stampacchia truncate functions TK and GK, where GK is defined as the difference between T and TK of T. We have also the following lemma that is very useful in order to prove a lot of results. In fact, it says that given P greater than one, and G a uniformly Lipschitz function such that G in zero is equal to zero with U in W01P, then the composition between G and U belongs to W01P. This is important because this lemma gives a way to construct test functions. In particular, since for Stampacchia truncate functions, the hypothesis of this lemma hold, we can use TK of U and GK of U, that is defined as the composition between TK and U and GK and U. We can choose this function as the test functions in the SQL. Since it is not possible to use a classical theorem in our case, in order to obtain obviously the existence of the solution of our problem, because we are in the hypothesis of non-coercivity, we follow a coercive non-linear approach inspired to the papers of Boccardo. So this is our approximate problems PN. And for these problems, we prove an existence and also a boundedness result for the solution UN. And now we are going to see how this is done. In particular, we start seeing the existence. In fact, the following theorem gives the existence of the solution, but for approximate problems by means of a surjectivity theorem. In particular, this is done for n equal to one. In fact, we have that this problem is our PM problem written in correspondence of n equal to one, but it is analogous for every n greater or equal than two. We report also an idea of the proof. In particular, we consider the operator A, and since we want to use a surjectivity theorem, we prove that this operator is coercive and it is a pseudo-monotone. That is, A is a bounded operator. That is, it transforms bounded sets of W01P in bounded sets of W to minus 1P. And A verify hypothesis 2i. In this way, surjectivity theorem applies, proving that the solution of approximate problems Pn with n equal to 1 exists. Later on, it is simple to prove that also the boundedness of these solutions it is possible to obtain. The most important result that we use in order to prove this theorem is the Lebesgue-dominated convergence theorem and the Fatou lemma, but the most important result is the compactness one that can be used since we choose E in an empty space. In particular, thanks to a compactness result, we can pass to the limit also in the non-coercive term. Once the existence of approximate problem is obtained, the aim is to prove the existence but for original problem. And in order to do this, let Un be the solutions of approximate problems Pn, we introduce two lemmas about Stampacchia's truncate functions. We have that the sequence of TkUn is bounded in W01P of omega, and in the proof of this result, we use the truncate functions as a test function. And we know that this can be done in view of the Stampacchia results seen before. Moreover, an analogous result is obtained for the sequence of GkUn, where Un is always the solution of approximate problems. And so Gk is bounded in W01P. Also here, we use the GK of UN as a test function. Later on, we arrive at a crucial point. In fact, this theorem says that if we know that UN is bounded in W01P, because the sequence of TKUN is bounded, the sequence of GKUN is bounded, and we know that GK of UN is defined as the difference between Un and Tk of Un. So this says that thanks to these decompositions of Stampacchia, also the sequence of Un is bounded. And the important estimate that we obtain in this result is that the constant that we have in the estimates is independent on the index n. So since Un is bounded, and we know that it is possible to pass to the limit in the variational formulation of our problem P, we obtain the existence of a solution for our original problem. We observe that the necessary instruments to prove this result is the compactness, the Lebesgue-dominated convergence theorem, and also the Vitari theorems used also in reverse sense. So this concludes this work, but what we know about the regularity results. We report an idea of these results that are contained in a paper joint with the professors Di Gironimo and Montserrat, and we consider the class of nonlinear coercive approximate problems depending on n seen before, and later on, we prove the boundedness of the solution Un in L to the power Pm star over P first, where Un are the solutions of approximate problems. And this is done also here using the decomposition of Stampacchia's truncate functions Tk and Gk. Later on, under these assumptions for E, the solution of original problem is in L to the power Pm star over P first. And successively, we obtain the same regularity result for U under more general hypotheses on E. And so we conclude showing that if we have these assumptions on E and F, then the solution of our problem P is also bounded. What about instead the uniqueness of the solution? We know that in the case of bounded domains, only a partial result has been achieved, that is for P between 1 and 2. So we can hypothesize that also in our case, this can be done for the same value of P. And in order to prove this, the following last result, the following last lemma can be useful, but this will be subject of future studies. So this concludes my talk, and here I report some bibliography. In particular, we observe that the first two contains the thing that we talk about today. We have these two papers of Boccardo that inspired our work. We have these three papers that contains the same results on unbounded sets. And we have this one and this other paper that contains the Tunket Stampacchia functions. We have these three papers about the empty space introduced by Transirico and Troisi. And this concludes my talk. Thank you for the attention.
Thank you very much for very interesting talk. So any question?
Okay, I have one question. Probably I missed it, but you have not mentioned here the result, the old result by Chico. Of course, he had equation of different structure with non-drift or in the non-divergent form, but then at least for the linear case, you can get results for your equation by using the duality argument, and then. How does result which you have in the linear case correspond to the result of Chica? What are the correspondences?
Okay, thank you for the question. In the linear case, the linear case are studied by Monsoureau and Transirico, and the papers is these three papers, and the correspondence between non-linear and linear cases is for the same regularity results. I want to take the problem. This is the problem, is this one. Just a moment, okay. This is our problem. And in the linear case, what we observe is that in the linear case, the regularity results are the same, but the hypotheses are obviously different because in the linear case, we have some different problems because we work on unbounded sets, but in the linear case, we have some difference because some theorems, for example, surjectivity theorem applies using some passing to the limit that in our case, due to the coercivity that we don't suppose, and since we suppose that the domain, our equation is non-linear, it is more difficult to pass to the limit. So we have to introduce some preliminary theorems. We proved some preliminary theorems that it is not necessary in the linear case. I don't know if this is the answer.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Actually, I meant something different. So let be equal to, right?
Sorry, you can discuss in the email.
Later on, yes. Okay. Thank you.
Let's thank again speaker for the very interesting talk.